Hello everyone, in this video let us try to implement a transaction. So as we know very well, a transaction is nothing but a set of tasks in which if at all a single task fails, it should roll back the rest of the task. Or you can say that my transaction is successful if and only if all the tasks are successful. If at all a single task fails, I say that the transaction fails. So from our earlier video we have inserted this record, so I have just deleted the record David. Now I want to perform this in a transaction. Basically you can implement transaction in stored procs. If you want to implement a transaction, you need a stored proc. So we have seen how to create stored procs in our earlier videos. So I'm going to create a stored proc. I'll simply copy this. I'll go for new query window. I'll say create proc name sp underscore my trans as this. Now what I need, first of all I need a try catch block in this. So whenever a runtime error occurs, so how do I write a try catch block? I simply write begin try and I'll say end try. So try catch block is to handle a runtime error, an error that cannot be determined at compile time. Then I'll say catch, begin catch, end catch. Now here I'll simply say that print error, I'll simply print error occurred. So now let me execute this. It should create a stored proc. So stored proc created successfully. Now I'll say execute my sp underscore my trans. So one row affected, zero rows affected, error occurred. So what it has done, it has not thrown an exception or it has not thrown an error. It has handled it. That means my execution has not got failed. What it did, it inserted this and at the time of this insertion it failed. So it went to catch block and it says that error occurred. So in this way I can handle runtime errors with the help of try catch blocks. Now let us see the data that we have. Even though we have handled the error with the help of try catch block, we are not able to roll back this record because we haven't implemented transaction. We have just handled the error. Now let me delete this record first. I'll just try to increase the indentation. I want everything to be in transaction. Inside this try, I'll say begin tran my tran. You can give any name. Once these things are successful, here I'll say commit tran my tran. If something fails, that is if error occurs, then I'll say rollback tran my tran. That's it. Now instead of create, I should say alter. Let me execute this first. Now let me execute the stored proc. One row affected, zero rows affected, and error occurred. Now it should not insert the David record. you do not find the debit record because the transaction got rolled back. Now, if the things are perfect, now I will execute this transaction. It says that both the records successful. Now let me see this. I get the debit record and its salary history record. So that's it. This is very simple. You need to implement transaction in stored procedure inside your TryCatch block. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much.